That's not your mother. It's a man, baby.
Hey, where are the white women at?
I've been said that there is no good black man that will be with a white woman. We all know that these black male swirlers are undercover booty snatchers.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Robert is a fucking swirler, y'all.
Hey, where are the white women at?
There is no good black man that will be with a white woman.
Hey, where are the white women at?
There is no good black man that will be with a white woman.
Now I think about
it. He's the fucking epitome of everything that Cynthia G talks shit about. Robert is a fucking swirler, y'all.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Robert is a fucking swirler, y'all.
I have admittedly, I never said I didn't. I've had sex with three white bitches in my life. I have.
There is no good black man that will be with a white woman.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Robert is a fucking swirler, y'all.
Admittedly, I never said I didn't. I've had sex with three white bitches in my life. I have.
Robert is a fucking swirler, y'all.
Hold up. Hold up. Wait a minute. Let me put my fist in it.
Hey, where are the white women at?
Robert is a fucking swirler, y'all.
Hold up. Hold up. Wait a minute. Let me put my fist in it.
Actually, my first boyfriend was white and me and him were engaged.
Hey, where are the white women at?
There is no good black man that will be with a white woman.
Now think about that and get your shit straight before you become the bitch that I hate, that I hate, that I hate, that I hate, that I hate.
Actually, I'm having a conversation, Cheryl, with you know who, and we were talking about, you know, whether women can eat other women out better than men.
I want to know when y'all gonna just come out with this, because it's just been this whole, you know, who.
Because don't nobody want nobody in their business. That's why.
Okay, fine.
And because if you just think about it, can you imagine just the foolishness that would happen?
Oh, yeah, it's going to be, it's definitely going to be foolish.
And so I'm just not about to put myself through that, neither is he. But we were talking about, because I was like, you know, I feel like it makes sense that a woman could eat another woman out.
What?
Better than a man could, because
yes, yes, I believe that, but I'm against homosexuality. I know that I just said I watched gay porn, but that was a long time ago, okay? So I'm not finna watch another woman eat a cooch.
Right. The thing of it is this, I don't support it either, but we were just talking about it because I said I wondered how women do it. And then he said, well, that makes just about as much sense as a man being able to suck dick better than a woman. And I'm like, that's not true.
But it makes good sense. They're chill persons.
Oh, wow. Elevated Goddess says she can't stand April Aries. Really? Why?
Can't stand me, honey, because we volatile. I can tell you why most people don't like us. We volatile, honey. We loud.
The funny thing is I feel like the March Aries are more volatile than April. Yeah,
they're nice. They're usually very grounded. We're the ones that are very volatile and just trash, I say. Oh,
see, I think it's the exact opposite. They're less grounded. They're loose cannons. Like,
I'm telling you. I know a lot of March Aries that are just like the total opposites of me. You know, I like to fight.
Two of my sisters and my brother is March Aries, and then my mom, my nephew, and the last dude I dealt with, he was an April Aries, and they were all very mellow. They didn't like drama. You had to, when you provoke them, then that's the difference.
You provoke, that's the difference though. So maybe it's that. Maybe she's provoked them, because unless I'm provoked, I'm chill as fuck. I don't.
Right. April Aries, you have to provoke them. March Aries, you provoke
me, though, you're getting a whole different breed. I'm gonna cut your ass out.
Yeah, April Aries, you can just look at them and then they're ready. Yeah. Like I can't with April with March Aries. March Aries,
no, I swear, they're so chill.
Wow, like none of them. They're chill.
They're chill.
They're chill psychos, though. They're chill psychos. Like looking for a fight. I won't deal with the March Aries.
I can't speak on it. I don't know. I thought we was the ones, because I swear everybody always say, like, y'all always the ones loud, obnoxious, we like them. Okay, fine.
See, I don't think they are loud and obnoxious. I think they have certain times when they can be lively, but most of them that I've seen, now attention whoring maybe, because my nephew is the biggest attention whore, and it irks me.
Oh.
But he's 10, so he'll mellow out.
Right.
He's 10.
Hopefully.
But he'll do anything for attention. He's so attention whorey.
That's so strange, because I don't like a lot of attention on me.
Yeah, he does. He everywhere he goes, he has to get up on stage, pretend to sing and act. And he'll be loud in people, like he's,
you know. But I know some other Aries that are April that they love attention on them though. But I really think that it has a lot to do with your moon and your rising too. You know, that's why I don't probably fit the category of what's, you're not like that. You're not like, well, you know, I'm a Libra moon, so we're more chill. We don't really be doing all that. I'm a little too calculated to be all loud and ghetto. I don't want people in my shit, so, you know.
Oh, Sasha says she's the Aries. That's probably why you don't like Libras. That's your opposite.
No, that's not the opposite. That's the one we love.
The opposite of Aries is a Libra.
Mm-hmm. And that's the one you're most compatible with. That's what they say.
No, not with mine. Because the opposite of mine is an Aquarius. And no. I don't even meet Aquarius men. Because I don't think that we would get along if I didn't.
And I would say, like, a lot of my Libra friends, I get they're just so mellow. So it's just kind of like, you know, we can coast a little bit. But I don't really come around too many Libras, so that I can't. I don't know about that. That's what they say.
SJ No Shield said her opposite is Leo. So you must be an Aquarius, SJ. If your opposite is a Leo, then you must be an Aquarius.
Yeah. It's weird though, because my sun sign is Aries and then my opposite is Libra, and that's my moon sign. So it's really weird how that worked out.
Yeah, my ascending is Libra.
Mine's a Virgo.
See, I like some Virgos. I won't say I don't like Virgos, because my older cousin, she's a Virgo, and I like her. But I don't. But my sister, who's a Virgo, and it's probably because she's in her 20s, so she probably needs to mature. But she's annoying.
No, and Virgos are older and the younger, are annoying, though. They are.
The older and the younger one, actually, their birthdays are 2 days apart. I think my older one is September 4th, and
they don't mean to be annoying, though. I don't think they mean to. It's just, that's just how they are.
Right, let me show you, baby. That ain't no woman. It's a man, man.
Okay, so for me, with men like Omari, who choose white women, across the board, there is, and I don't care who's mad about this, there is not much difference in the countenance of a homosexual man and a black man that dates and marries white women. There is a feminine energy that they walk in, and it is because, I don't care what anybody says, these are men that are seeking protection and trying to take refuge from white supremacy between the legs of a white woman. So when you enter into these relationships so that you can be shielded from white supremacy and use her, you are under her, you are under her covering, you are still under, you literally are the submissive in the relationship, even if she placates to your manhood and makes you think that you're head of the household. She knows the dominance that she has over you. This is why those women say, and we've seen this happen with the other football player, who said, the woman said, I'm a white woman. They're going to believe me. This is why they get to do this shit. They know the dominance that they have over black men, and black men who choose white women arbitrarily over black women, like Omari, most of them have that in common. These are feminine men, and tell me if you're wrong. And see, the thing is, if you ask the men, they won't say this, but ask any black woman if these men don't have feminine qualities. They're very feminine. They're very girly, and they are literally submitted to these white women.
Okay, so if they're feminine guys, why would you want them anyway?
Let me tell you something. I don't want anything with a man that chooses white women. You understand? When I see men with white women, I instantly am not attracted to them. I don't want them anyway. So, okay. And then the mindset that black women are pining over these men. Maybe there are some women that are feeling a little some kind of way because they're with white women. I'm not interested in you when you date. It's sick to me because there is something, and I put this picture to people in their heads all the time. You can put the most dominant looking, dark skinned, masculine, muscular, Zulu warrior type of black man, and if you picture him and you put him on the arms of a white woman, that masculinity starts to dissipate. And that's what happens to me psychologically when I see black men with white women. That's just me. So I don't know. I don't care. I'm never jealous.
Right. I actually said earlier when they brought up the good man going to white women earlier, I had been said that there is no good black man that will be with a white woman. We all know that these black male swirlers are undercover booty snatchers.
Admittedly, I never said I didn't. I've had sex with three white bitches in my life. I have.
However, black people need to stop having kids. When you're a hood rat and you can't afford it, then you need to be more responsible sexually. Because if you feel like you're not financially and mentally equipped to have a baby, then don't have one. There is a reason why I'm 34 and I've not been pregnant and don't have any children. Not because I couldn't right now, but because I don't feel like I'm in the right position to have a child. I don't want it to be financially stressful. I don't want the man to feel like he's been in a situation where he didn't want a kid, he wasn't ready for it, and now we're falling out and the baby is having to be in some dysfunction. I want it to be a planned situation, therefore I'm not getting pregnant. Until I'm in the situation that I want to be, then I'll have a child, because I don't want to struggle. I don't want to be engaging in hood rat behavior like this. I don't want to argue with my baby's dad over dumb stuff. I don't want to do that.
She left the party, have a good time. She looks so hearty, feeling fine. She left the smoke, sometimes shifting cold. She'd be laughing.
Let's say all the truth.